Welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. In this video, we're going to make a pack grill. I'm going to show you how to turn this into this. Very compact, extremely compact. So stay with me and let's go into the shop and let's make it. Okay, we're in the shop here, and first we're going to go over what we need for this project. Okay, this is a little grill that I bought at the thrift store for $2.99 US. This is a piece of all thread, 3 foot long, that I bought, that is number 8. 32 threads, 36 inches long, and here is some 8/32 thumb screws or wing nuts, thumb nuts or wing nuts that will go on the all thread. And we need a pair of crutches. I bought these crutches also at a thrift store for $4.99. And last but not least, we need a cup of coffee. All right, let's get into the tools that we're gonna need. Here are the tools that you'll need or want. I'm gonna use a marker here. This is a dry erase marker. I like using them because then the marks are generally easy to erase. Using the tape measure, I am gonna use my hand grinder with a cutting disc on it, but you could use a hacksaw. Again, here you're going to need some sort of a drill. You can use a hand drill and a hole punch, but I'm going to use my drill press and a drill press vise here for this project. But like I said, you could use a hand drill. All right, now if there's anything I forgot, I'll mention it as we go. All right, let's go over what I've got accomplished so far. This is the dozen crossbars that I've cut off of the 1 minute. Cut off of the grill. Okay. Here is the two pieces of the crutch that we are after. Okay. I can see that the inner one is longer than the outer one, so I may cut off the inner one. Now, how I got that apart, you'll see that there's some rivets through here. So I took a drill bit and I drilled the rivet until I drilled this top off. Then I took the hole punch and a nail and drove it on through. Okay, same with up here. There's a rivet here and a rivet here. That holds this plastic piece on this particular pair of crutches. So I drilled those out, knocked them through, knocked this off, and pulled out the two pieces I needed here. Now, as you can see, here is a spring clip so that you can adjust the height. Okay. And so I removed that clip from the interior of that rod. In the end of each of these, there was a cap. I took a wooden dowel, stuck it in the end, in the opposite end, just like a ramrod, just popped it and drove these out. Okay, so now we have these two. Okay, these holes here are much too large for these rods, okay? And we only want the holes to go through one side. So I'm going to mark this. I'm going to mark this. And we'll take the hole punch, pop it a little indent where we want each one of these rods to go. And I'll come back when I've got that done. Before we go any further, I just wanted to show this. It just simply pulls off. Okay, here's the completed grill. I'm going to call it the PackRat Pack Grill. Okay, let me go over a few things with you to explain a few things before we put it together, before I show you how it goes together and what it looks like together. I placed this hole in from the end, I think it was at 3/8 of an inch. And then I went 1 inch, 1 inch, 1 inch, 1 inch, 1 inch. Those five holes. I did the same from the other side. Okay, well, these two holes, they ended up being about 1 inch apart. So it worked out well. Okay, that may not be close enough to like lay a hot dog across the grills with the grills. You can certainly lay a hot dog this way across the grills and it'll work fine. So you may want your holes placed closer or farther apart. That's up to you. Okay, now to make those holes straight, I laid something flat on the counter on the workbench, and I laid this next to it and I marked a line across the top of that item. Piece of plywood might help, perhaps a book if you can find a book this long to use as a straight edge. Okay, then I went through and I took a nail punch and I punched on each one of these holes just to make a little divot to keep that drill bit from wandering. Okay, because I wanted these holes to line up as close as I could get them to line up to straight. They're not completely straight, but they're quite close. Close enough. I drilled a pilot hole with a small bit, and then I used the size bit that was needed, that was just big enough that the rods will slip in easily. All right, now for the ends, I made some sheet metal caps. Let me show you that in a little better detail. Okay, you can see the detail now. It was just a round cap. I placed this vertical over the piece of sheet metal and then drew a line around it to mark out the circle. And then I drilled a hole and then I cut out to the hole with tin snips and then filed the hole smooth. I clipped off the corners here just so there wouldn't be a sharp edge there. Okay, that works well for keeping everything contained in the unit. Okay, weight. How much does this weigh? It weighs just under 1 pound 2 ounces. Which may seem kind of heavy, but I was surprised to find out that it was actually about 4 or 5 ounces lighter than the original grill. This is actually lighter
than the original grill. Okay, let's assemble this and I'll show you what it's like together. Show you how sturdy it is, how durable it is. Okay, now on these rods did not end up exactly the same length. So what I did was I'd go through and I pick out the two longest ones and I'll put those in the two end rod locations. These two last locations here, those are for the all thread. So let's go ahead and put this together. All right, now I'll show you how the top goes on. It's a little bit fiddly, but it's actually not as bad as I thought it would be. I just work my way up, putting each rod in as I get to it. And there we go. Hopefully I was in the camera view. There we go. It's time to put the two all threads in there. Now, as you can see, the rod holes only go through one side. They don't go through the other side. The all thread goes through both sides. All right, that's it. It's completed. Now, as you can hopefully see, this is very sturdy. Okay, I'm gonna grab it by one side here and shake it. It is not going back and it is not going back and forth at all this way, and it doesn't go back and forth this way either. It is very sturdy. The rattling you hear is each one of these inner rods here. They will slip a little bit, but it's very good and sturdy. Well, thank you for joining me. I hope you learned something. I hope you enjoyed the video, and we will see you folks on the next video. You take care and have a good one.
If you enjoyed this video, be sure and give it a thumbs up and to share it, as well as subscribe so you don't miss any more. And check out these suggested videos here. Thank you.